Hey y'all, welcome to Renee's Secret Garden. I am back to show you guys what I'm up to out here in the yard. Well, recently I have noticed that I am not organized at all. I'm not as organized as I thought I was because I noticed that when the season started to change, I started looking all around the house like, I thought I had some seeds for this. Where are my seeds for that? And I thought about it like, you need to stop doing that, because if I have extra seeds, what I would do is just tie them up in whatever bag they're in and just toss them somewhere on the bookshelf, in the garage, just wherever. Not organized. I know. Bad. Shame on me. I know. So I started doing a little digging and found out that some people keep their seeds in containers and all sorts of little things. And when I saw the containers, I was like, I don't want to do that because it's too big, too bulky, take up a lot of space. And then I saw some people save their seeds in the pockets, like little sleeves to go inside notebooks. I'm big on notebooks. I was like, okay, sign me up. Where do I get it? So I got on Amazon and I found some sleeves that had pockets just for you to protect your seeds. Hello, that's perfect for me. So when I got on Amazon, I found this, and it has 50 in the pack, and it has 4 pockets on each protector, on each sleeve. And I said, okay, that's perfect. Got that. It was about $15 for 50. And let me show you guys, because I want to really show you guys how they look. They're actually kind of thick. They do have 4 sections for your seeds. And the seeds are actually pretty good size. So you can probably put 2 packs of seeds in each pocket, to be honest, if you really just was trying to do it like that. But I already had a binder at home from when I got my childcare credentials. So I just used my 3-inch binder that I already had at home. It's pretty big and durable. And I want to decorate it. I want to decorate it and put my own little creativity on there. I'm not really creative, so let's just throw that out there. But I like for things to look cute. So, you know, it is what it is. But yeah, that's what I'm doing in my garden. I got this off of Amazon for about $15 or $16. I can't remember the exact price, but I know it was around there. And I actually got it a while ago and just been sitting on my dining room table. And I want to show you guys how it looks. So I'm going to get more organized. I got to keep telling myself that. And I also want to start a garden journal, because I want to start keeping track of the things that I try in my garden that work, that don't work. Locations will work for one plant, may not work for the other plant. So I want to start keeping a journal, a detailed journal, as far as the care of my plants and where I'm putting them and what I'm doing to the soil and things of that nature. I really want to go into depth with that, because I really have noticed that when I plant certain things on one end of the yard, it may not do well, but if I plant something else on that other end of the yard, it may just flourish and just take over. So I really want to start getting into exactly what's helping each plant. My herbs are doing well. I'm getting ready to start cutting those back, because fall is starting to come in and you can kind of see the sticks now. It's time to start cutting my sage back. I want to make some sage wands. I made some about 2 years ago, loved it. And I'm going to also cut my mint back so that it can come back fuller and more bushy. What else? It's just time to cut back on a lot of things so that it can, you know, give me more next year. And just for the aesthetics alone, because my sage just looking sad over here because that frost has started coming in, so I need to do something about that. But my peppers are still going. Like, I I've been in love with my peppers this year. I know y'all getting tired of me talking about my peppers this season, but my peppers have been beautiful this season. I'm so in love with my bell peppers, my jalapeno peppers. Oh my goodness. My tomatoes have been so good to me this year. The only thing is that when we got the family dog, he started running through the he started running through my vegetables. That's a no-go. So something has been done to help with that. And I'll talk to you guys about that in another video. But for now, I wanted to come to you guys to talk to you about my organizing of my seeds. I'm about to get started and I'm about to, you know, really, really get into, oh, this is the back, the thank you that came with the thing. But I'm about to really, really get into saving my seeds and preserving things a little bit better. And next year I want to start jarring. My grandmother's been talking to me about that. She's been trying to get me to do that for a long time. I don't know what it is about me, but I have this thing where I'm scared I'm gonna mess up. I don't want to jar something up and then when you go to open it to eat it, you die. Because you have to be really careful with that. You have to like wipe down your jars really good with the vinegar rag, and you have to make sure you seal it up tight. You have to seal it a certain way. And I'm going to try it with maybe one or two things. I don't want to go overboard, and my first time trying, I try to do too much. So I'm going to start off with something small, try to jar up maybe one or two things and see how it goes. But yeah, I want to get into that with my journal. That's going to be a part of my journal that I keep also. So my garden journal is not going to be just the landscape. It's also going to be like trial and error, things that I've tried and it did work, and jarring is going to be a part of that, or shall I say preserving. Yeah, so because I got a lot of fruit trees out here too, I want to start preserving my peaches and my pears, and I just want to do better. How about that? I just want to do better out here. It's not just about how it looks. I want it to actually do something. Like, I don't want it to just look cute. I want it to have purpose. Put it like that. Purpose. Yes. So I really thank you guys for coming along this ride with me, this journey with me. I'm not perfect by any means. I'm just your average down home girl that just like to get out here outside and play in the dirt and make it happen. And I like to feed my family. I like to feel like I'm feeding my family. So thank you guys for riding with me. I want y'all to stick with me. And if you have anything that can help me, if you have any advice, just, you know, put it out there. So I will talk to you guys in the next video. Gracias por ver. Thanks for watching. Bye.